Regarding the social dialogue, considering your discussions you had in the last days in Romania and what's happening at European level, so the institution, the Economic and Social European Committee, which is functioning, it's so important at European level, but it would be also important to have this kind of dialogue at this level also
yes.
in Romania. But it is not happening right now at the
no, it's just it's just starting. So I think that the first meeting Wednesday in the National Tripartite Council of Social Dialogue was quite successful, because the social partners and the government agreed on their rules of procedures. It was maybe a little complicated, but they agree, and I think it's a start. So I just came here to encourage this dialogue. I know that for the dialogue with NGOs in the framework of the Romania Economic and Social Council, they still have problems to organize their work, and I encourage the Prime Minister and to speed up the process to establish a real economic and social council in Romania, as it is in fact in the constitution. So I see some encouraging factors, although they need more culture of dialogue, more culture of respect, respect of each other. But I'm quite confident that this will happen.
This will happen soon, hopefully. Because you visited all the European countries in during your mandate. What model for social dialogue do you think it's? Where did you see the best as a best practice?
No, I don't think there is a best model, because each country has its history, its past, its okay. But I think the best example are in the countries, Nordic countries. I would say Sweden, Finland, Austria, Germany, where there is a culture of respect, and where the government normally don't interfere in the social dialogue. And I think that it's best to have direct dialogue between the social partners, what we call autonomous dialogue. And I understand that in Romania, some other countries in this part of Europe, there's a tradition of a very active state. It's the same in France, anyway. But I think the most evaluated system, the best, is when it's real autonomous dialogue without participation of the state.
But also the government should take into consideration the opinions of
but sometimes we don't need the government. For example, if you see the situation in Austria or in Germany concerning a lot of regulation, they are decided directly by the social partners. We don't need the government. Why to involve the state? State is just there when there is really a need, when we cannot find a consensus. But if we find a consensus, we don't need the state, just the state to implement. But the decision should be in the hand of a social partner. It's what we called self-regulation. Self-regulation by the economic and social actors. Don't need to have always someone political who could interfere in the dialogue. And this is why also I think it was a good decision for the Romania Economic and Social Council, because in the past it was employer, trade union and state to replace the state by the NGOs. So because a real civil dialogue, it's without the state, without the public authorities.
Okay, thank you. You also mentioned that you talked with the Prime Minister about the investment plan of the European Commission. And you mentioned some problems regarding the possible financing for Romania, which includes the corruption issues.
Yes.
Can you develop?
Yes, of course. No, because I know from my own experience that investors are always reluctant, specifically in developing private-public partnerships program in infrastructures, when they feel that it will be very complicated because of administrative burdens and because of possible corruption scheme, mainly at local level, municipalities, region, and so on. So I saw yesterday, I saw today, I think, in a newspaper, a report on corruption in the cities, in mayors, in municipalities in Romania. It's not encouraging. So these are real problems.
So there is still such an image about Romania.
Yes, the image, economy. which is quite, which is also unfair because corruption exists everywhere. But the fact that it's not just an image, unfortunately, it's a reality too. Plus the image, it's a double punishment for Romania. So I really. I'm impressed by the efforts of DNA, your agency, anti-corruption agency, of the effort of your government, the effort of the volunteer of a president, and I think it's this is very positive, but it takes some time to take effect.